Spend the wealth that I've given you before death comes to you. Why? Why should one spend their wealth before death comes to them? And I say this because wallahi al-azim, you know, in the last few weeks on my Facebook page, I've been looking at, you know, I mean, nowadays social media has become, you know, just depressing. You open social media, a Facebook account, and or even your WhatsApp, and you get these messages. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. So-and-so died, so-and-so had passed away. And one of the most common now things I hear very commonly is someone just passed away suddenly in their sleep. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Now I think to myself, and I think to myself, and I say, imagine if that was me. Imagine if I went to sleep tonight and didn't get a chance to wake up. What was that one thing that I would want to do before I left this world? For me, if it was me, in my case, I would say to myself, I would have given charity. Because that's the only deed that will continue after I die. That's guaranteed to continue. I wouldn't say, oh, I would have loved to read Quran, or I would love to fast, or give, or you know, go to pray at the mosque. No, I would have told myself, I should have given charity. And this is exactly what Allah has told us in the Quran. وَأَنْفِقُوا and give of your charity, of your wealth, in the cause of Allah, مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ أَحَدُكُمُ الْمَوْتِ before death comes to one of you. And when death approaches to that person, they will say, فَيَقُولَ رَبِّي لَوْلَا أَخَّرْتَنِي إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ فَأَصَّدَّقَ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. That person will say, I wish, oh Allah, you just extended my life for a little duration so that I could have given charity in the cause of Allah. Imagine, out of all the regrets this human being will have, is the moment that they didn't give charity before they died. Just think of that for a moment. And you know, nowadays, alhamdulillah, we have so much opportunity to give charity. So much opportunity. So many fundraisers. So many appeals, so many moments being asked to give in the cause of Allah. Do we take advantage of those moments? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his quality was that whenever someone asked him to give in the cause of Allah, he did not wait for one moment. He would always give. To such an extent, one day the Prophet was reading the prayer, the Asr prayer. And in the middle of the prayer, he remembered that he had a stack of gold in his house. He had a stack of gold in his house. As soon as he finished the Asr prayer, he didn't talk to anyone. He didn't look at anyone. He got up from his place, jumped over the shoulders of the people behind him, and went straight into his house. And the Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, what is going on? Why are you so hasty? Why are you rushing? He said, there was some gold that I had in my house in possession. And I feared that I might die with this gold, so I gave it in charity before it becomes something that's accountable to me. Charity that you give is not accounted for. Right? That's wealth that Allah will never look at and account for it. It will just be hasanat for you. But every wealth that we have and we keep, remember that it will be accounted for with Allah. So tonight, you're going to make an impact. You're going to leave a legacy in the life of children. And how many of you have heard the Kashmir crisis? Raise your hand if you have heard the Kashmir. Everyone, I'm assuming, right? We've been seeing it all over the news. We've been seeing it not as much as we want. We should be seeing more on the news. But alhamdulillah, helping hand works in Jammu Kashmir, in Azad Kashmir, in the lines of the conflict. And they provide help and assistance to those people. In the valley of Kashmir, providing help and assistance to the children there. And many of them are going to need help tonight. We heard of the Palestine crisis for years. Children who are displaced, living in Jordan and Lebanon, who don't have any place to go, they need your help. The children in Syria who have ran away from the crisis there and the bombing of Aleppo, and in the Mishra, they ran away to take shelter in those foreign lands. They need your help. The children of Africa, in Somalia, in Uganda, in Kenya, in East Africa who are drought-stricken, who don't have any access to basic water, basic education, basic healthcare, and the list goes on. So inshallah ta'ala, tonight your contribution, your support will go a long way. And we're going to start off from a number inshallah ta'ala that I hope to see participation in. And we're going to make a lot of dua for them. So there's two things in my fundraising.